Thine be the glory, risen, conquering Son. Good afternoon to all. The hymn you have just heard has over time become one of my favorite Easter hymns, and of many others that I know as well. The musical accompaniment in itself possesses a joyous character, and even if at any time words were not used, one could imagine a heralding, triumphant declaration of brass and drums, signaling to all that something significant has happened. On this Wednesday in Easter week, as we continue to live and breathe, we are reminded by the rising S-U-N that the S-O-N has also been raised and continues to live today, working in and through us to the glory of God. This hymn appropriately reflects the gospel for today. We may recognize that today's gospel on the resurrection, Matthew chapter 28 verses 1 to 16, parallels that of Mark 16 verses 1 to 8 and 9 to 20, the gospel readings for Monday and Tuesday respectively. What we discover is that there are some differences between the two. For example, in Mark's account, the women took spices to the tomb to anoint the body of Jesus. But in Matthew, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary were simply going to see the body. In Matthew's account, an earthquake occurred as the stone was removed from the entrance of the tomb by an angel. But this does not exist in Mark's account. Again, in Matthew, guards were standing watch by the tomb. But there were no guards at the tomb in Mark's account. Quite a few differences beyond these are evident, but despite this, it is important to note that the outcome remained the same. Jesus rose from the dead. As the hymn says, "Endless is the victory thou o'er death has won." The centrality of this event was so important that the church continues to this day to acknowledge and celebrate each year at this time, that we have been released from the law of sin and death. For us, we recognize it is, however, strange and a new experience not being able to celebrate the resurrection as we are accustomed. Today, many of us are locked away in our homes, attempting to keep active, as we do not fare well with being still for too long. That is quite understandable. The elements of COVID-19 have taken the world by storm and has affected our routines and even our spiritual lives, which adds to our personal afflictions which have not left us, but continue to simmer in our thoughts. But even though all around in our communities our way of life has changed and continues to change, the resurrection still occurred. We do not acknowledge it each year because we saw it with our own two eyes, but because we believe in what we have heard. So there is light. There is light of the sun, S-U-N, which reminds us each waking day that the sun, S-O-N, lives, and so we too live. There is light in that as we keep our faith, all shall be well. All shall be well. And all shall be well, and all manner of things shall be well. So today, as we continue to adapt to the changing scenes of life, let us remember the significance of this Easter week, where Jesus the Christ conquered death by rising to life, so that we, who believe, might be saved. Thine be the glory. Let us pray. O God, whose blessed Son made himself known to his disciples in the breaking of bread, open the eyes of our faith, that we may behold him in all his redeeming work, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. As we continue our daily proceedings, may we also remember those who are on the front lines, all our medical professionals, doctors, nurses, and other persons who are working as essential workers to help us to continue in the routines that we need to continue in so that we may continue to thrive as communities.